So we've seen Emily Blunt as Mary Poppins twice now, as she was captured on set just the other day. Again, the first photo being official, and she's awfully good at hiding her face. But now we have an official look at Lin Manuel Miranda as Lamplighter Jack. And I have to say, I was initially underwhelmed by this photo with two nagging questions. And instead of just taking the photo at face value and walking away disappointed, I decided to look for the answers to my nagging questions. And in doing so, I actually fell in love with this photo and discovered that this script might actually be, get ready for it, well researched. All right, so my first problem was that I was expecting Bert equivalent. You know, dirty, cockney, a working man, salt of the earth, and didn't fit in the neighborhood. On a side note, Dick Van Dyke will return for this sequel, but not as an older Bert, but as the head of the Fidelity Fiduciary Bank. That's a role he played in the original, Mr. Dawes Sr., and now he will play, this movie taking place about 25 years later, Mr. Dawes Jr., who was played by another actor in that film. But now he has matured into Dick Van Dyke as well. And Colin Firth will be reporting to him, and I imagine is now Michael Banks' boss. We'll talk about Michael Banks a little bit later in this video, because there's an interesting connection. But anyway, back to Lin-Manuel Miranda's Jack. He looks so great, I thought he was like Admiral Boom from the first film. You know, an upstanding member of the neighborhood who decides to help out, Admiral Boom telling everyone the time, and Jack lighting a couple of lamps. But I looked it up. I actually found photos, as you can see, of lamplighters in the 1930s in London, and it seems that this is exactly what they looked like. They made an effort to dress up a little bit for their job as they walked the streets lighting the lamps, and it was a great job that wasn't particularly dirty, and it wasn't hazardous to your health like being a chimney sweep, but it was no less pivotal to, you know, the evolution of life in London and employment options, because they brought light to the city by going around and sparking sparking the gas that was coming up through the streets, which seems pretty dangerous to me. Thank goodness this isn't a Batman movie, even though it does have the title of one. So that was settled. I was like, okay, this is what a lamplighter looked like at the time. But then I was like, this is my other nagging question. I was like, with all due respect to Lin-Manuel Miranda, who, as I think Jimmy Kimmel correctly said, is now an American treasure at this point, is this just tokenism forced on the movie to try and appeal to modern audiences? So I decided to look up UK immigration history. This photo, I really wanted answers to my questions, as you can see. And in doing so, get this! There really was immigration in the 1930s, particularly from Spain. Starting in 1936, there was actually an influx of Spanish immigrants trying to escape the Spanish Civil War, a huge war in the history of Spain, and actually is a situation that seems similar to many points of immigration throughout time, including today, escaping a war in your own country. So who knew? 1930s London was diverse. And I'm pretty sick of history making it seem like diversity is something new. Like back in the day, everyone stayed in their own countries. For instance, I had to find out from the History Channel, despite going to, school here in the United States, I believe good schools, and I never knew that there were, Africans who lived with the Pilgrims. You know, they always make it seem like the only way the people came here from Africa was in slave ships. Not true. Obviously, the majority did, and it's horribly tragic and a horrible part of our history here in the United States. But that's not the only way people came, and they were here free first. So I think it's a wonderful thing to bring attention to, and it's a perfect fit for Lin-Manuel Miranda, who highlighted Hamilton as an immigrant and helped different ethnicities form a connection to American history, which they probably were a part of anyway, but history just, you know, wiped them away, which is tragic. And now this Mary Poppins Returns seems to be doing that for London, and Lin-Manuel Miranda is helping out once again. And this photo becomes quite powerful, particularly with the UK flag in the background, because you're showing an immigrant happy to be in his new country and holding a pivotal job to, again, the evolution of the quality of life in London and employment options. And I just think that's really powerful stuff. And I hope this will be further reflected on in the film, and they will call attention specifically to London's immigration history. Maybe even a nice song. Because London is a very diverse city. Today, it has a very large Middle Eastern community, and it also is the very first Western city to have a Muslim mayor currently. And that's a major turning point as well. And if you saw the recent Paddington movie, which wonderfully brought to life a UK treasure, that movie really focused on putting Paddington in the light of an immigrant from Peru, which I thought was wonderful. And he was voiced by Benoit Shaw, who plays Michael Banks in the Mary Poppins sequel. I think that's absolutely fabulous. So finally, a shout out to screenwriter David McGee for hopefully being this smart. I hope that truly is the case, and that's woven throughout the film. And it doesn't come across as tokenism, because it shouldn't. For a little bit of a background on David McGee, he is a screenwriter. He hasn't done a lot. He wrote Finding Neverland, and he also wrote The Life of Pi, and he was a co-writer on Miss Pettigrew Lives for a Day. He's also writing the upcoming Chronicles of Narnia Silver Chair film. But this is his. He's writing it solely, and I hope that he has done as good a job as it seems. So what do you think of Lin Manuel Miranda as Lamplighter Jack, both when you first saw the photo and now that you know all this backstory? Write your thoughts down below, and if you'd like to hear my thoughts on Emily Blunt as Mary Poppins, our first look at the character, the link is down below in the video description, and you can click also here right now.